So this is what I've said. Before me, for determination, are two diametrically opposed applications seeking fiercely opposed orders. The first application is dated 20th March 2019, filed by the DPP, seeks to take away the life of this case, while the second application, filed by the applicant, seeks to breathe life into this case. The only common factor between the two applications is that they owe their genesis to the history of this case. Talking about the history of this judicial review application, this judicial review application was instituted by the applicants, and subsequently the court gave directions and hearing and filing of pleadings. And as the record shows, the parties complied, and the matter could have by now been determined were it not for the numerous applications made by the parties. Relevant to this application before me is the application by counsel for the DPP and the first interested party, supported by the other interested parties, seeking to cross-examine a deponent to the affidavit in support of the judicial review application, that is a Mr. Singh. The application was made pursuant to Article 50 of the Constitution, which grants a person the right to challenge and adduce evidence. Fully conscious that judicial review applications are determined on known and well-defined principles of law, and acute aware of the provisions of Section 12 of the Fair and Administrative Action Act, which imports common law principles to the Act, I allow the application. In so doing, I upheld the Constitution, read Article 50, and directed that the deponent attends court. On the date scheduled for his attendance, his court was confronted with a medical report stating that he was unwell or unwell and unable to attend court. Subsequent mentioned dates also show that the applicant was not still, that was showed the subsequent mentioned dates also, the court was informed that the deponent was still unwell to attend court. At the time of making the order, the court stayed the criminal prosecution against the applicant. The upshot is that, as of now, he has not been able to present himself to this court for the purpose of cross-examination. The DPP moved this court by way of the first application, that's the one dated 20th March 2019, seeking orders to vacate or set aside or review or vary the orders requiring Mr. Singh's attendance. He also seeks an order to set aside the order staying the prosecution. The third order seeks to have this suit dismissed for want of prosecution. This last prayer or the last order is premised, in my view, on Order 17, Rule 2, that it does not meet the legal test. This suit has not been dormant, as we all know, it has been very active. Dismissal for want of prosecution is where a matter has not been active or a suit, no action has been taken. So I say no more about the last prayer on account of that, because that's really a clear point of law. The applicant seeks an order that the orders made on 11th October be vacated and that this suit proceeds to full hearing. Now, faced with these two diametrically opposed positions, the court that all of this is understandable, but the record shows that the application that gave rise to the order, which now brought us where we are, was supported by the DPP and both the interested parties. So what we are going through is the consequences of the order. And the consequences of the order, then unforeseeable, must be addressed with fairness. And also, the entire blame cannot be meted on the applicant. Talking about prejudice and fairness of the case, I am reminded of the less drastic means of addressing the situation. First, this is a judicial review application. Traditionally, we all know that such applications are addressed by known grounds of the law. I may not go into merits of the application for obvious reasons, but I can state that this application will stand or fall on these non-grounds of law, whether we like it or not. Second, if the contest is on the contents of the affidavit, then the unless drastic means is available. That is, the parties can invite the court to strike off the offending paragraphs or seek leave to file supplementary affidavits to reply to the allegations or even make submissions on the same and ask the court to make inferences, whether adverse or otherwise. In short, the less prejudicial means of addressing this affidavit is opposed. In short, there are less prejudicial means of addressing this affidavit as opposed to dismissing the suit or even vacating the order in question. It follows that there is no basis for the court to make such a drastic order of striking off these proceedings as invited, nor am I persuaded that there are solid grounds to vary or set aside the order staying the prosecution, especially considering the delay in the case can be attributed to all the parties, in particular the history of this case. So the upshot is that the application by the DPP dated 20th March 2019 is refused. The application dated 24th April 2019 filed by the applicant is allowed. The orders flowing therefrom are as follows. The order made on 11th October 2018 directing the cross-examination of the applicant and all the other deponents is be vacated and all set aside to that the case proceeds for determination on the basis of the affidavits, files and submissions. Three, respondents, the interested parties, are at liberty to file further affidavits if need be to address the paragraphs cited in the affidavit in question. So the parties are also invited to take a hearing date almost immediately, not to hear the case now, but you will take another date to move the case forward. And lastly, I found no basis to order on cost, nor was I asked by any of the parties. So if all of you are in agreement, we can agree on a hearing date now.
Well, in the light of your lordship's order,
yes,
it follows that in the interest of justice, the earliest possible date be given to the parties to come and highlight the written submissions. We've all put in our written submissions.
Yeah.
So what I don't know, the earliest possible date.
Does anybody think of doing further affidavits? Because I left that window open, because I didn't want to close all the doors.
As far as KEBS is concerned, we do not. But
I can see everyone shaking their head so that they don't have to file.
But if any party wishes to do
and so, the order remains either
way. Yes, they can do so within the next 10, 7 days or so. What about towards the end of
July? Let us check. I don't keep the diary because I give myself all
the dates. What's the earliest dates? End of July, early August?